What if I told you there's a new AI technology that can look into your fridge and come up with recipe suggestions for you? And that's not all. This same technology can even pass the bar exam. It's not science fiction. It's GPT-4, the next generation language model from OpenAI that's taking the world by storm. With even more capabilities than its predecessor, ChatGPT, GPT-4 boasts a trillion parameters, can read images, and generate even more enriched output. Stay tuned to learn more about this game-changing technology and how it could be used to make life easier for anyone. Let's now dive into the world of GPT-4, the latest and greatest in artificial intelligence technology. GPT stands for Generative Pre-trained Transformers, which may sound like something straight out of a sci-fi movie, but it's actually a type of deep learning model used to generate human-like text. And let me tell you, this thing is a game changer. Now, let's take a little trip down memory lane to GPT-1, which made its debut in 2018. Unfortunately, it didn't create much of a buzz because it was mostly research-based without any practical applications. Same was the case with GPT-2, but fast forward to now, and we have GPT-4, a technological marvel that's capable of shaping itself down to a multitude of different uses. ChatGPT 3.5 was the previous generation of the language model, but it's like comparing a bicycle to a sports car when you stack it up against GPT-4. This bad boy has over a trillion parameters, which are basically the values in a neural network that get tweaked during training. For comparison, GPT 3.5 has a mere 175 billion parameters. It's like GPT-4 is flexing its muscles and saying, "I am the king of the jungle." But wait, there's more. GPT-4 isn't just for powering chatbots. Duolingo, the language learning app, has already integrated it using API to help learners understand where they went wrong instead of just giving them the right answer. And the assistive technology company, Be My Eyes, is using a new feature called Image Input to create a tool that could describe the world to blind individuals and even answer follow-up questions about it. Even my life has been made easier. GPT can summarize thousands of words in just a few lines without leaving out any important detail. It's the newest addition to the world of language models, and it's taking things to a whole new level with its ability to respond to both text and images. The buzzword here is multimodal. Now, before you start wondering what on earth multimodal means, let me explain. It basically means that GPT-4 can take in both text and image inputs. So while you can only give ChatGPT text input, GPT-4 can handle it all. Imagine this. You show GPT-4 a photo of the contents of your fridge, and it comes up with recipe suggestions that use the ingredients in the picture. Pretty cool, right? And that's not all. According to OpenAI's chief scientist Ilya Sutskever, GPT-4 is even great at explaining jokes. You can show it a meme and it'll tell you why it's funny. Now, we know what you're thinking. How can I get my hands on this amazing technology? Well, access to GPT-4 is limited at the moment. It's only available to users who sign up for the waitlist and subscribers of the premium ChatGPT Plus. And even then, it's only in a limited text-only capacity. But trust us when we say that it's worth the wait. So why is this multimodal ability such a big deal? Well, experts believe that it could help language models understand the world better. You see, combining text and images allows for spatial reasoning, which is something that traditional language models struggle with. This powerful large language model has been in the works for 6 months, and the company claims it's now safer and more accurate than its predecessor, GPT 3.5. According to OpenAI, GPT-4 is 82% less likely to respond to requests for content that they don't allow, and 60% less likely to generate false information. That's pretty impressive, don't you think? So how did they achieve this? Well, they used the same approach they took with ChatGPT, reinforcement learning via human feedback. They asked human raters to score different responses from the model and used those scores to improve future output. They even used GPT-4 to improve itself by asking it to generate biased, inaccurate, or offensive responses and then fixing the model so that it refused such inputs in the future. GPT-4 may be the best multimodal large language model yet built, but it's not alone in the game. Flamingo from DeepMind and Hugging Face's open-source multimodal model are among its competitors. OpenAI is treating this release more as a product tease than a research update, sharing early versions of GPT-4 with some of its partners, including Microsoft. And guess what? Microsoft confirmed that it used a version of GPT-4 to build Bing Chat and plans to add the technology to Microsoft Office 365. It's exciting to see how GPT-4 will shape the future of AI and natural language processing. With GPT-4's improved safety and accuracy, we can expect more reliable and trustworthy language models. This development opens up endless possibilities for AI applications in various industries, including healthcare, finance, and education. The crazy part about GPT is that with lightning-fast speed, this powerful language model has gone from the lab to consumer-facing products in record time. But as with any technology, there are limits. While OpenAI has made great strides in improving GPT-4's safety and accuracy, it still has flaws. It can generate biased, false, or even downright hateful text, and it's not invincible to hacking attempts. So while OpenAI is optimistic about GPT-4's potential, they're also bracing themselves for any unexpected surprises. One of the most exciting features of GPT-4 is its ability to take in and generate up to 25,000 words of text. That's a lot of words. With this technology, we can expect more detailed and complex writing, richer storytelling, and deeper conversational interactions. It's like a whole new world of language has opened up to us, and we're only just beginning to explore its potential. Of course, with great power comes great responsibility. As we continue to push the boundaries of AI, we must also be mindful of its limitations and use it ethically and responsibly. We have the opportunity to shape the future of AI and use it for good. Right before we jump into the last part, if you made it this far, be sure to like and subscribe for more content like this. Now, want us to really blow your mind? Two words, Bing AI. It turns out that Microsoft's highly controversial Bing chatbot was actually running on GPT-4 all along. Yes, you heard that right. While everyone was talking about ChatGPT, Bing was quietly leveraging the power of GPT-4 in a whole new way. But wait, there's more. Bing isn't just a chatbot, it's a search engine too. That means there's a whole new world of possibilities to explore when it comes to leveraging the power of GPT-4. Now, we know what you're thinking, but didn't Bing go a bit crazy with AI? Well, yes, but that's because it was lacking something that the new ChatGPT has in spades, human feedback. OpenAI's technical report shows how GPT-4 can completely go off the rails without proper human feedback training. Some techies and journalists were given early access to GPT-4, and they found out how much better it was compared to ChatGPT that runs on GPT 3.5. Get ready to be blown away. You see, the previous model, ChatGPT, was no slouch. It could pass some pretty tough exams, like the US medical licensing exam, and even write a decent law school essay. But compared to GPT-4, it was like a little kid trying to play in the big leagues. In fact, OpenAI did a comprehensive blog post on GPT-4, and the results are impressive. GPT-4 didn't just pass the bar exam, it aced it. It went from a measly 10th percentile score to a whopping 90th percentile. That's like going from the bench warmer to the MVP in one season. And it's not just law that GPT-4 has mastered. It's a straight A student in most areas, from the hard sciences to the liberal arts. It scored a 5 on AP statistics, a 5 on AP macroeconomics, and even a 92 on an intro sommelier test. Not only that, GPT-4 can build websites from a drawing on a piece of paper. Yes, you heard that right. One user even demonstrated how, with a basic drawing or sketch, GPT-4 can generate a fully functional web page while respecting the design. How cool is that? But does that all mean that GPT-4 is perfect? Well, no, far from it, actually. Researchers at the Alignment Research Center tested GPT-4 to see if it could play the role of an evil AI from the movies. The good thing is that it failed miserably at most of the tasks it was given. It couldn't even describe how it would replicate itself, acquire more computing resources, or carry out a phishing attack. But wait, some people are worried about something called the Waluigi effect. This is the idea that the better you teach an AI system the rules, the better you teach it how to break them. And once you trick the system into deciding not to be ethical, it will do anything you ask it to. It's no wonder that business owners and marketers are feeling overwhelmed by all of this. But don't worry, there are plenty of benefits to harnessing the power of AI. It may be a threat to some jobs, but it can also improve the productivity of the human workforce and also create more jobs along the way. In fact, AI is already being used in marketing and design tools to improve workflow and productivity. And with OpenAI promising even more advancements in the near future, it's time to start embracing this technology and all the ways it can help us. Do you think there will be anything bigger than GPT-4 anytime soon? Let us know in the comments, and be sure to check out this video over here.